Did you realize that the average person in the US is exposed to EMFs for over 10 hours a day? This really shocked me, but if you look at it, it does make sense because we're exposed to your smartphones, computers, laptops, Wi-Fi, internet routers, microwaves, and the list goes on. And these devices are putting out invisible electromagnetic fields that definitely interact with our own body's electrical fields, both in our brain, in our heart, and even in deep into the cell. But the good news is this, that experts assure us that EMFs are not harmful. There's no link between EMFs and anything negative about your health. But I don't know if I agree with that, because there's a report that was put out in 2012 that evaluated 2,000 studies. And they found that this low-level radiation can play a role not just in Alzheimer's, but a lot of different conditions. It can affect your blood pressure, it can affect your pulse rate, it can cause you to have insomnia, it can make you tired, it can affect your cognitive function, focus, memory, concentration. It can actually raise your inflammation, cause muscle aches and mood changes, and even increase your risk for getting a stroke or a heart attack, and it can cause DNA damage. Other than that, it's perfectly healthy, according to the experts. And so the EMF waves affect the channels, the communication channels in your cells. They're calcium channels. People know that calcium is involved with bone, but they don't realize that calcium is the main mineral involved with communication through the membranes of every single cell. And these EMF energy waves directly affect the communication channels across all your cellular membranes. So presently, we are doing a huge experiment on the human population with EMFs. So I'm going to highly recommend doing three things. Number one, you have to start limiting exposure to EMF, okay? The way to do that is to get a EMF tester. I'm going to put a link down below of the one that I use. It's pretty easy to use, and I've created a couple of videos to explain how to use it. And you just turn it on, and you can measure three things individually: the electrical fields, and then separately the magnetic fields. And I explain what that means in the videos down below. But if you have one of these testers, you can measure on your desk where you sleep. And a fascinating experiment is to measure your microwave, if you have one. And you're going to be quite shocked how far these microwaves transmit through your kitchen. It's quite scary, actually. And the next time you use your microwave, you're going to definitely stand probably outside the room when you use it. All right, number two, keep your cell phone and other devices away from your head. Okay, do not do this. Keep it away from your head. Use your speakerphone. I talked about certain type of external headphones or earphones that you can use that limit the amount of radiation that goes right up into your brain. And then number three, you want to increase your antioxidant network. Why? Because there's a lot of oxidation, a lot of free radical damage occurring when you're exposed to these EMFs. So you want to beef up, no pun intended, your antioxidant network. A lot of raw vegetables would help, cruciferous vegetables, healthier foods, and fasting can all increase your antioxidant network that can help counter a lot of the EMF effects from your daily exposure. Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.